Well, our first guest is Mr. Tuomas Aslak Juuso, a Sami from North Finland, and since 2007 has become a regular in the global international indigenous movement. He started in the Global Indigenous Youth Caucus and grew into the spokesperson for the Sami and the Arctic in many different processes, including the World Conference on Indigenous Peoples. He's currently the president of the Sami Parliament in Finland, and he's serving his third period in the parliament. One of his main priorities at the UN is the enhanced participation process for indigenous peoples, representative institution in the UN General Assembly and Human Rights Council. He is the one that came with the idea for this webinar series. So Ghazali, please help me welcoming Tuomas.
Oh, thank you so much, Ini, and this is a great initiative, and thank you so much for hosting this whole thing as well. Jumping real quick into it, Tuomas, full disclosure, yes, he is the guy that came in with this idea from the get-go. Just taking you like a month and a half back, he came up with the idea, and yeah, we just played around with it, and now it's actually coming to live. Very good friend of mine. We make a lot of fun of the work that we do, as in like we have a lot of fun. So we have a lot of fun in the work that we do. In my mind, one of the world-class political minds, upcoming political minds in the indigenous movement that we can enjoy. So hopefully, where is Tuomas? Yeah, there he is. Tuomas, because you started this whole thing, let me start off by giving you the floor for an opening statement, State of the Union. What are you seeing, thoughts on governance, diplomacy in the now for 2 minutes before we go into questions?
Well, thank you, Ghazali, and it's good to see that this series have been happening now and starting from the beginning. And it's been a couple of nice 2 months, and it's really nice to see that this is happening. I mean, first of all, it's a pleasure to have a topic of indigenous governance and representation as a topic. And I really think that this is a good way to familiarize and a little bit explain a little bit more what are the indigenous representative institutions and how indigenous governance, how indigenous diplomacy should be done. And I really much want to also listen to everybody that has been registered as a speaker to this line. I think you have the top line in the world, and I'm humbled to be part of this group. Of course, indigenous diplomacy and indigenous governance is really important, and through our functions, through our actions, we are having the opportunity to try to improve the situations of indigenous peoples, also towards the United Nations. Currently, representative institutions where I'm coming from, the Sami Parliament in Finland, we don't have a direct access to United Nations. We cannot participate to all the relevant meetings for us, as we cannot register as an institution to them and to UN. So I think indigenous governance diplomacy is really relevant to the enhanced participation process, what we are now struggling within in the United Nations.
So let me take you a little bit to the now. How did you react as an institution? You're the president of the Sami Parliament in Finland. How do you react as an institution to the pandemic? And what are you doing to come out strong? Any thoughts on that?
Well, of course, the pandemic has been a new challenge for us as an institution. We do represent officially the Sami people from the Finnish side in the national and Finnish context. We have the Finnish constitution and national legislation behind us. So in order to fulfill that task, you of course would have to have the utmost best opportunities and possibilities to represent your people. And of course, the COVID-19 situation has been challenging for us as traveling, for example, to capital where most of the decisions are made, and where we live from North Finland, that is 1,000 kilometers away from capital, has been a challenge. But I'm proud of our institution and our secretariat that we've been able to keep the level of work and participation in a proper level, even though everybody of us have been working from home and through Teams or Zoom or these equipments that we have. So it's been a challenge, but hey, we've been able to work and negotiate with the government and do our tasks. So I'm happy.
Awesome. Also, because I want to go quick here because I got so many questions for you. You bring as a president a lot of international experience to the parliament, to the Sami people. What value does your international work or the international work at large bring to the people to the Sami people, to the people that you represent?
Well, of course, Samis have had a lot of capable people working on international field for a long time. So there are and have been experiences, of course, that have also guided me how to work in the international field. So I think that my experiences can work as an example and know to how the newcomers and those that will continue one day these works or are willing to participate at the international level. But I think that in our institution, we have been able to prioritize and build the structure for the international work. In our parliament, we have established Secretariat for International Issues just last year on a permanent basis. And that is a huge step in our work in order to be capable to follow all the UN processes, EU processes, all where we are, Arctic Council, cooperation with the other Sami parliaments. So it allows us to work with a certain level.
Awesome. Talk to me about the strength and responsibility of being an indigenous leader at your age. Top challenge, failure, maybe aha moment for aspiring indigenous leaders that are looking up to you?
Well, I'm though quite young age, still 35, so definitely the responsibility side is something that has to be always understood when you are representing and working on behalf of an institution that actually represents the whole people. So that is really crucial to understand that you are working as a leader and you have the responsibility to the institution and to the people. But it's always important to remember that you don't work alone. You have your own people, as we in the parliament have parliamentarians that I do work together and make decisions with them. So I'm just a form of representation of that institution that includes a lot of people, a lot of work, and a lot of expertise. So somebody has to be leading, and I've been given the responsibility. Maybe some aha elements or experiences might be that you always, especially maybe with a younger age, want to do quickly stuff. You want to help your people push issues with the fast time and reaction time. And maybe it's good to remember that in this work, it might take years or tens of years before you can reach levels that are acceptable to your people to push issues forward. And I think that is something that I have learned from the last couple of years being in the leading positions of the Sami parliament.
Tagging a little bit into that and unpack that a little bit. How do you grow? Because like you talk about aha moments, you grow as a leader. How does your growth, how does the parliament grow with that? And also take into account your international experience. Does that make any sense, that question, by the way?
I mean, it does. I mean, every individual brings, of course, different kind of capacities. And especially parliamentarians have different backgrounds, different knowledges, and combining those together will allow you have a good basis ready to start your work and start to reach out for outside. I think that one of my strengths that I've been, I have been in a good position to learn from some of the most greatest minds that I consider in diplomatics overall. I've seen some of the our, not elders, but like those people that have been doing the representation work in the international field for tens of years. I've been able to see and follow them for a long time, how they conduct themselves, how they negotiate with governments like Canada, Finland, Russia, China, how they use the diplomatical spaces to push forward issues. And I think that is one of my great strengths and privileges that I've been able to learn and see. And I'm trying now to of course, building on all the strengths that I've been able to learn to help the parliament also push their and our agenda forward together with others. Many capable individuals in our parliament, and we're definitely working together.
Before I continue with the questions, Twitter, how can people reach out to you? What's your Twitter handle? Because I already see some tweets going on, like people like making some great takeaways. What's your Twitter handle?
Yeah, you can find me on Twitter on TAJUUSO.
All right, awesome. So TAJAA, what?
TAJUUSO.
UUSO. All right. People keep attacking this guy. All right, President, international experience. The next 3 years will be very crucial. Paint me a picture. What does success look like? How will you know, like, this is it? I did it. Give me a personal story or a personal picture and a professional picture, if you can.
Well, I hope that we, at least here on the Finnish side, are able to defend and strengthen the Sami Parliament's role. Some of listeners might know that we have a tricky situation now with the Parliament's mandate with the government, and we hope that the Finnish government would fully respect the rights of self-determination and indigenous self-governance. And I think that is something that is really crucial to everybody also to remember that in order to be successful with your issues, you have to be working with multiple fronts. You have to be working on your own people. You have to be working on the level where you are located. You have to be working on a national level, but you have to be working also at the international level in order to get the full push for your issues in the decision makers in those countries where you are. But also when you are practicing the right to self-determination and making your own decisions and an institution, it's really important that those decisions are real and accountable, and there is a clear accountability for the people, so that you have the full mandate from the people to represent. And I think that is, if I would say, not maybe a personal success or goal, what I'm trying to achieve, at least from my profession, the goal, what I'm going and trying to achieve to be exercising full power.
All right, so final 2 minutes. Personal observations, things that you are seeing as a leader in terms of representation in the world. Give me a good thing and a bad thing. What are you seeing?
Well, I'm happy that the indigenous movement is still going forward and working together from all the seven regions. I think that has been our strength, and I think that is and will be our strength in the future. I hope that, for example, in the global movement of, for example, saving the world and trying to get some sense to the world, that the current direction where we are is not maybe the best one for our future, needs people from the indigenous movement to participate also. And I hope that that the indigenous movement and our own institutions all around the world will grow stronger, strengthen their representative nature, and are capable of working together even more stronger.
Awesome, man. Thank you so much, Tuomas. I know we can talk for much more longer, but I have like a crazy lineup, people waiting after you, trying to top whatever you just said. Thank you so much, and I'll give it back to you, Ini.